Well, I saw a review on this some while ago, and I always fancied getting one for myself. And I did see one had become available. It was a stupid price, it really was, but I had to have it. It's a Russian mountain ration. You've probably seen them before, seen the reviews. This one itself was packed in 17, but it expires in 19, so only a 2-year shelf life on this one. The ingredients I cannot make out whatsoever, although I have seen one of these opened up. I do know that it contains 5 20-gram chocolate bars, which I thought would be a pretty decent on-the-go supply of chocolate, so you could just munch them as you're out in the field. Anyway, less of the chat and let's see what's inside it. I've already tried to see if I can peel it apart to preserve the packaging. I can't, so what I'm going to do is just open it with my knife without trying to destroy the insides. Oh well, that's destroyed the... So let's start spreading this stuff out then. Now, as I said, this is a huge ration. It's over 5,000 calories here. Nice little tool for opening packaging, or I don't know. 5 water purification tablets, 6, sorry. 2 flameless ration heaters. A mediocre supply of toilet tissue. 5 packs of crackers. One has survived totally unscathed. The rest have been shaken around a bit, but that's no problem. And we have 5 useful sources of energy, 20-gram chocolate bars. Have a coffee. 3 big sugars. 2 tea bags. 3 dried berry flavoured drinks. Looking at the colour, maybe it's something like raspberry or something along those lines. 1 stove and tabs, windproof, waterproof matches. Nutella chocolate spread sort of thing, salt and pepper. Despite the piece of spam, this is cheese, I believe. I've just translated what all of this is. This one is a apple butter, apple preserve. Look forward to that actually. I hope it's as nice as the Zapple sauce that you get in other rations, US rations. I couldn't identify this. It's some kind of kaja. This one is shredded beef. This one is beef and pasta. I'll try and spread it out so you can see how much there actually is in it. This is porridge with meat and rice. Porridge and raisins, rice. And a rice soup with meat. So they're the 3 dried rations there. Now here we have amateur mint sausage. That might mean mature sausage, I'm not sure about that. This is an apricot fruit bar, and these are disinfectant wipes. One is for cleaning your cutlery, your mess kit. The other's for cleaning your hands. And we have 3 spoons. The spoons, not as good as the US brown MRE spoons, but a little bit firmer than most. So that there is in excess of 5,000 calories. So I'm going to have some cheese and crackers first while I decide what I'm going to have for my entree. Difficult choice, there's just so much of it. I've got the courgette sizzling away nicely there. I'll go for the pack of biscuits that sustained the most damage, or crackers I should say. Okay. Kind of slightly salty flavour. But texture's nice, nice and crispy. Be very nice with a bit of cheese. Oh, the cheese is soft enough. Strange kind of powdery texture to it, but it's okay, nothing wrong with it at all. It's just a processed type of cheese. Yeah, it's nice. Well, my entree has heated through. Now, I thought I'd boil it in the bag like this so I could get the most out of the fuel tabs. It's a very pale fragrance to it. It looks nice and interesting because of the packaging. Doesn't come with any creamer, any kind of dried milk. Whoops. Oh, there we go. Now the entree. Put a little tip back in there. It looks like a kind of beef and wheat porridge. It smells lovely, that's for sure. Just get the nose over that with pie lentils in it or something. Break that up. Oh, it looks like corned beef. So I'd say this beef and buckwheat porridge. It's got kind of Eastern European flavour to it, very similar to the Lithuanians. Not unpleasant at all. I'd be quite happy with that on the menu. It wouldn't be a bad surprise or anything. The flavour, it's really all right. It's a shame that I've only got one sachet of pepper with it, because I'd like to put a bit of pepper with it. But I want to save that for one of the other entrees. But I would describe this as very, very nice, very filling. Look at that. Beautiful. And the coffee will go a long way. This has gone quite a long way. Kind of dark, bitter. I could have made a big cup, a 300 milliliter cup out of that. Didn't put sugar in it. I wanted to taste it as it was from the packet, and it's okay. It tastes like coffee. It's not great, but it's not bad either. So that's the unidentifiable courgette beef. Probably says beef. I mean, it's got corned beef in it. I did enjoy that, actually. I've decided to put a little bit of sugar in the coffee just to see if I can get any more out of it. It's a bit of a strange flavour. It definitely tastes like chicory. But there's nothing wrong with it. It's probably got caffeine in it. It'll keep you awake. So now for my pudding, I'm going to have a little bit of apple butter on a cracker. Oh, look at the colour of that. Oh, that looks very nice actually. What does it smell like? Oh, wow, that's really lovely. Oh, it tastes like the filling from one of the pie you get from a supermarket, that very processed, more apple than apple flavour. Mmm. Oh. Oh, there it is, yeah. Sorry about that. Yeah, that is very nice. Mmm. Mmm. Oh, listen to me crunching on this stuff. Mmm. Well, I'll fold that down and save that. I'm not going to pig out on it. And there seems to be some sort of clip on this opening tool that I could probably use to hold this closed so it doesn't all run out. Look at that. Might be what it's for, might not be what it's for. Tell you what this is for. Oh, that is just so nice, it really is. Mmm. Very lovely. Not one that's been into chocolate spread, but I'll open this and try it. Looks a bit darker than the Nutella hazelnut spread sort of thing. Let's try this. It smells nice. Mmm. Well, the few mouthfuls of this ration that I've had so far, say mouthfuls, they are several hundred calories that I've consumed already. Been very enjoyable. Mm. And I'm going to make sure I've got some of this left for lunch. So while I go back to the day's work, back again, I will have this chocolate bar for some on-the-go energy. I can't make out anything on the back, what says calories, what says what. But it looks nice. It looks quite dark. It looks like a sort of 65% darkness. Mmm. It just tastes like a slightly fattier version of a high quality dark chocolate. Mm. It's just a shame they're only 20 gram bars, but I'll see you lunchtime. Well, lunchtime already, and I think I fancy some of the porridge wheat with meat. Now, it actually does really look like porridge with little bits of meat in it. So let's get that hydrated, boiled up, and also fancy these as well. So I'll warm those up and we'll see what lunch is like. But I must say, what I had for breakfast was very enjoyable indeed. And whilst our amateur sausage is heating up, let's try a little bit of the dry berry beverage. Oh, that's a lovely smell. That's a probably blackcurrant, raspberry, two totally different fruits, but I can't really identify the smell. I don't want to overdose it too much with water. It's a lot of sugar in it. And mix it with cold water. Oh, yeah, that's nice. I would say mix it with cold water. It's not going to dissolve the sugar very readily. And because there's so much sugar in it, maybe it's supposed to be a tea, I don't know, like a raspberry tea. Oh, that's nice. That would be nice. I'm out of the way. That would be really nice, hot or cold, you know. I think it's probably the right amount of water for it. It's just right. It's not too sweet or sickly. It's not too thin and watery. It's a nice colour, beautiful flavour. Yeah, lovely. Going down very well. Okay, now I think my amateur mince sausage has warmed through. I'm going to use the hot water hope I haven't put too much water in there. Porridge normally thickens up. I probably have put too much water in there, but we'll see. We'll give that a couple of minutes. Well, my meat porridge is starting to thicken up a bit. Let's have a look at the amateur sausage. Oh dear, that's strange. I don't even want to read the instructions to actually see what is in it. But let's break it up. Okay, it's got a thick kind of spam-like thickness to it. Christ. Whoa. Well, that is salty, fatty, no doubt hundreds and hundreds of calories in each mouthful. But it's rich. Yeah, actually that's very nice. I've never eaten anything like that before. Yeah, that's lovely. It didn't last long, unfortunately, but my porridge is starting to solidify now and have some kind of consistency to it. This would undoubtedly be a very, very filling meal on its own. And I will buy another one of these rations sometime, even though they are stupidly expensive here in the UK. I would have one of these for a breakfast. Now, in comparison with that sausage, this is very thin. Flavour wise, it's got a nice kind of consistency to it. It's meaty. Got a kind of vegetable bouillon type of flavour to it. The little pieces of meat haven't quite hydrated yet, but it's not a bad flavour at all. And you can see that that is just going to be packed full of carbs, which is exactly what you want. Yeah, this I should have started as a breakfast. Yeah. The sausage that I just had, I don't know where that fits in. Maybe as a starter, not sure. But this is going to go down very nicely indeed. Very filling, it's very satisfying, very hearty. Well, I have to say, I feel absolutely stuffed. I'm not going to make a tea now. I fancy another one of these rather nice dry berry flavoured cold drinks. I'm not sure if you're supposed to have it hot or cold. There would be no problem having it hot, especially if you're having this mountain ration in the winter time. Generally it is colder up mountains anyway, about a degree I believe colder for every 1,000 feet you go up. Now I think that was about the right amount of water, so that's a good cup, I guess about 300 ml. And for my pudding, I'm going to have some of this rather nice apple butter. I don't know why we can't buy stuff like this in the UK. We can buy jam and stuff like that, all kinds of preserves, but this is like a, it's almost like a pie filling. The sauce, the natural flavour of it, tastes very much like the sauce in the US MRE, the apple pieces in sauce in the number 24 MRE. But this itself is beautiful, really is. And I've still got so much left. I've still got over a kilo of food left in this container. And I don't know how I'm going to find time to eat it all. But I'll manage, believe me. Oh, very nice indeed. So I look forward to coming back at dinner time and sampling some more delights from this menu. Oh yeah. See you soon. Actually, before I take any more out of this for lunch, I'll just weigh what I've got left. I mean, it's still over a kilo left. 1.25 kilos of food still left. I mean, that is an amazing ration. It might have cost me more than I would spend on myself for a week shopping, but it was just so important that I tried it, because I've got to know what it's like for myself. I've seen other people's reviews, and they've been great reviews, and the ration itself has looked amazing, but I had to try it for myself. And as I've just said, I'm feeling stuffed, and I haven't even eaten all of the components yet that I should have had up to my lunchtime. So I don't know how long this is going to last, but after dinner tonight I'll see how much I've got left, and maybe do another review to see how many days it does take me to eat it.